So anyway, you know, when I saw that on the news, like, you know, of course, the other two were crossed over. Now the dude who killed himself was tripping, crying, and, you know, like, he re-saw what he had done. He was regretting his actions already. You know what I'm saying?
Scared.
Scared. Scared about going to hell. And there is no hell.
There's no hell to be burned in.
So I took him through the portal, you know. I mean, I went right on through, took them on through. I arranged to have Christ, Buddha, all of them meet them and forgive them. I know some of that stuff, some of that, that's not all what a lot of y'all want to hear. Y'all want to hear the stories of the devil coming to get them, to burn them forever and all of that. But that's just a lie.
It's not
going to
happen.
It's not going to happen no matter what you do. But he needed help getting over. He was begging for help. I'm not going to say no to anyone. It could be Hitler asking for help. I would take him through the portal.
Yeah,
you know, let me say that. You know, but
a lot of people might get mad about that too.
A lot of people get mad, but that's the truth. I would take, you know, I'd take anybody through. I've taken serial killers who were executed through before and come for help.
Yeah.
I've taken child molesting priests on the, who are in self-imposed exile dimensions in the spirit, one, some spirit world, one of the spirit worlds. I crossed them over. I crossed over a nun who murdered her baby and threw it in a trash can after it was born, strangled it, threw it at it, you know. She refused to go through the portal for fear of going to hell and God's wrath and all this. I did that, you know. I crossed over one of Al Capone's hitmen, you know, who was a ghost.
Yeah.
You know. I crossed over a young black dude from Essex Village, you know, who killed like two or three of his ex-girlfriends in a jealous rage and then blew his own head off. Police pulled him over in Maryland. He came to me sobbing one night. You know, I had an 8-year-old help me cross him over. 8-year-old, son of a friend of mine, he's able to see spirits perfectly, hear him, and he knows what he's doing. He helped me right along. This young dude came weeping and crying, begging for help, because he had enough of the self-imposed exile. He'd been there for years, you know, just sobbing, like, please help me, please. Yeah. And when you see the crying, you know that they're ready. You know, so we just took him straight on, straight away. But that when we speak of this, this dude, I've never seen such a gentle person. Because afterwards, we took him through the portal and got him healed and all. Like, he came back and sat with me. And sat with me for several days around me a lot. I felt him behind me. I felt something warm on my shoulders and warm behind on my back. I was sitting at Christy's house. And Christian, the little 8-year-old son who could see spirits walking, and said, well, the guy who killed all his girlfriends is sitting behind you. That said it like that. He said he's smiling. He said he's rubbing your shoulders. You know, had a hugging you, you know.
He must have looked highly upon you.
He did, you know, that's what I felt. He, like, he, the gratitude. I felt this pure gratitude and love. And gratitude and this pure thankfulness. And just for what we did.
And all this is a healing process, you know. I wrote on my board today, take time with the wounded hand because it likes to heal. And this is what we're doing. A lot of wounded hands, a lot of wounded spirits, a lot
Wounded
soldiers, a lot of wounded people, you know, family members.
But all
we're
around.
We're here to help heal.
Help heal. Help heal. Heal anyone that's wounded, no matter what you've done.
No matter what. You know, judgment.
No judgment at all. We're here to help. Like, we're here to help the families who are survivors of homicide, and we're here to help people who have committed homicide.
Right.
And,
even the ones that committed suicide.
Even the ones that are dead and committed suicide, we're here to help y'all.
Yeah, we're working with them.
And we're here for everyone. That's the point. We're here for all people. Every single person. We can go over an hour. We got a few minutes. We're on a roll here.
Yeah,
we got time.
Yeah, we're good.
You know, we'll be at an hour in about
1:30.
About a few more minutes. We're going to keep going.
Yeah.
You know, we're on a roll, so we're going to keep talking, you know. We decided that instead of stopping every 20 minutes for a break, it's better just to talk than record, because we are going to get on a roll. This is how Jeremy and I talk when we're off camera a lot, you this talk like this. This is this is the things we ordinarily talk about.
If you're a fly on the wall, you hear just what you hear here, pretty much. You know, same conversations, same truths, same situations, dealing with spirits, taking them through portals.
Yeah.
Non-judgment. Best we can.
Yeah.
Just doing the best we can.
It's like that. I didn't interrupt, but the lesson I learned from that guy who killed his girlfriend and himself, the young guy, is a good lesson for you guys too. I know how gentle he was and how loving this guy actually was to heart once he had been healed.
Yeah.
He was a serial killer and murderer and committed suicide and all this stuff. But yet, once he was healed and someone took the time to show him compassion and love and took care of him, he was gentle as a lamb, gentle as a little kitten or puppy, just sitting there hugging me. I felt his arms around me. I felt him. I could feel him on me, It wasn't nothing gay or anything like that. He was wrapped his arms around me, I could feel warmth and energy going into me. It was just childlike love, pure love, admiration, and stuff. Anything like that.
This has come out of me. Compassion, love, handle with care, and be easy. They're very important things to do. Compassion, love, handle with care, and be easy.
Very true. Very true. That is very true. Excuse me, I'm gonna keep on going. I'm just writing. I'm keeping a running tally of what we talk about so we never have a problem writing good descriptions of our videos again. Processing our spirits to do bad things.
It's time to light this earth up with some positive energy and get some things popping while we are here on the planet. I think that's a lot to do with, like I said earlier, unity, being there for each other, showing compassion, forgiveness, those kind of type of things. You don't have to forgive through Jesus. You don't have to, forgive yourself, forgive your friend, forgive your family. Forgive who you need to forgive.
Yeah, you don't have to ask any particular person, the infinite or Christ, anyone to forgive you. You can, but the truth is that you need to learn how to forgive yourself.
Yes, because learn more compassion.
If you
lack compassion, you're trying to find out how to get some.
Compassion is really, really important. Yeah, I can say that. It's really important. Let me just check our recorder to be sure we're recording properly. Compassion, man, is so important. And, it's so important. If you can't be compassionate, it's okay, but you'll learn to eventually. But the compassion is just critical that you be like that. Because I've found the reward for compassionate living is so great, it's unfathomable. Just even a little compassion practice from the heart will give you such immense spiritual power and euphoric thing.
Sorry, man.
I spilled this a little bit. I'm getting excited. See, I get excited when I talk about compassion. You see, I got so excited the coffee got knocked over. Can you write it down? Sorry about that. Compassion. But this compassion does excite me because just like the slightest little practice of it, if you just practice a few hours a day or hour a day and then we're moving to more and more compassion, you'll get high. And you actually become high on compassion. And the compassion high is a spiritual euphoria that has no description. There's no way to put it in words. But it's no drug that is in existence compares to how that feels continually.
Exactly.
It makes you want to do anything. It makes anything fun. It makes anything you can do in your life fun. It makes everything a pleasure and enjoyable, and it makes it a beautiful thing to do. And we're doing fine.